off the concrete.
Channel, I feel like I haven't really talked to you guys in a minute, so every time I start back talking to camera after I haven't been talking to the camera, it's been weird. Anyways, so first starting off, I'm gonna go ahead and wet my beauty blender. Then I'm going to wet this. I've been using these all over my face. Okay, so like I really want to talk about a lot of things right now as far as updating you guys on me. One thing we can talk about is like being a Christian in this time period. So I'm gonna just go ahead and put 338 on, and I got 338 and 340 because most of the time I have to like try to blend these to get my perfect match. Life update. I got so many questions to ask you guys that I'm going through right now. It's like, how do you be a Christian in this time period with everything so over-sexualized and like everybody hates our president right now, it seems like. It's just like, how do you be a good Christian, like a devoted Christian, like you're not dipping and dipping and whatever they call it. Like, how do you do that in this time period? Because that's like the journey I'm taking right now, is being a Christian. How sway? So if you have a like answer to any of these questions that I'm gonna be asking, please comment it. Like, pause the video and comments, like, how do you be a Christian in this time period? Oh my god, this looks so light on me. But it really, I feel like this foundation gets darker when it oxidizes. But like, being a Christian in this time period, I have been told to just pray a lot and read my Bible. And recently I downloaded the Bible app, and I've been like pleasantly surprised at everything that's on the Bible app. There's so much on there. There's devotionals on there. I just finished one of them, a 10-day devotional. And of course they have their daily quotes and stuff, but it's hard out here in these streets. Temptation, and then just like with me being only 22, it's like I want to live my life, but I feel like when I was out there living my life, I kept failing, you know, in different areas. And it's just like, bruh, you really need God in your life, so just go ahead and surrender to God. So I don't know why my beauty sponge looks like this. This is the Walgreens one, so I don't know what's going on with it. I'm gonna try to blend this into my skin. I might need another layer. Give myself away. I give myself away. So you can use me. I give myself away. Give myself away so you can. So I was inspired by Face Over Matter to do a video like this, where she gave us her playlist of music. My playlist is a little bit different. I have a worship playlist, and then I have a lit Christian playlist. This is the worship playlist, so you know it's gonna be a little more slow paced. It's gonna be, you know, worship. But I was definitely inspired by Face Over Matter, so I just wanted to shout that out in this video. Okay, back to regular broadcasting. What helped you with your walk with God? What helped you? For me personally, what helps me with my walk with God is praying, reading the Bible,
worshiping and having that godly community, I'm gonna list my playlist in the description of this video. Please check that playlist out. It's a bunch of like sermons and like motivational speeches that I really have really speaked to me and like really helped me. So I feel like that can help somebody else. I'm gonna go ahead and what I'm gonna do, I kind of want to put my eyelashes on. I'm gonna put my eyelashes on before I do my full face. Cultural triple push-up collection. Ooh, these are the lashes I'm wearing. These are like my everyday lashes that I have been wearing for the past few weeks, maybe a month. Okay, maybe a month or two. But these are the lashes I've been wearing. I like to reuse lashes. That's why I don't mind spending $5 to $10 on a pair of lashes, as long as I can get like multiple uses out of them. These have been giving me problems though. I don't know if it's the glue I'm putting on it, but it's been giving me problems. Okay. I usually stick to my eyelashes because those literally last like a long time. If you're taken away from my walk with God, you gotta go. I don't like the term cutting people off because it just sounds harsh, but and I'm not cutting nobody off, but I'm gonna love you with a long handle spoon. I'm not cutting anyone off. I don't like that phrase. I don't like it because I've used it before and I've done it before, and it's just, you can love somebody from afar without cutting them off. That's what I've matured to. So yeah, you definitely need a good community, a good like circle of friends that can go on this walk with you. That's been the hardest part of my journey, is finding friends that will go on this walk with me, because a lot of people just are living their lives carefree, YOLO, and this time period is so hard. I feel like a lot of things are more acceptable. Like, it's just a no-go for me. Like, I'm trying to be a queen, I'm trying to boss up. And a lot of the times, I can't really clearly get that across to some people. Y'all, all 2018, self-care, all 2018. Like, you gotta take care of yourself. I'm definitely gonna get a massage next week. I kind of want to travel somewhere, like, kind of impromptu. I want to travel somewhere, like, maybe, like, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Come back. Refresh. But I want to travel somewhere. I don't know if I'm going to go to Chicago, Texas. I don't know where I'm going to go. But I'm going to go somewhere for the logo. And that's what I do know. Okay. Let me try to put these eyelashes on. I will be right back. I'm going to just touch up on my eyebrows, because I already had my eyebrows done earlier today. But I've been doing stuff. Oof. Okay, so I can't be the only one that's experiencing this, but what is so irky is people just not letting you be great. Like, if I say I'm choosing to be a Christian, I'm choosing to live for God, you can't be like, dang, just 2 weeks ago you were out drinking, and remember this, or remember you did this last month, last year. Like, let me be great. Can I be great? Like, I'm trying to change. So I don't know how to tackle that situation of people just not accepting you wanting to change. Like, that is the most hate. Like, I feel like you low-key hating on me. Like, if that's not your choice, that's not your choice, but it's my choice. I'm just like trying to live for God. And I'm gonna be honest, like, I think it was two weekends ago, I'm out, I'm drinking, you know, I'm supposed to be having a good time. Music was nice. People were in the, you know, venue. But I just wasn't there spiritually. Like, spiritually, I was thinking about getting some sleep for church. Like, I can't wait to go to church tomorrow. I was, like, really happy about the church I'm going to. So, I'm like, man, I want to be early this time. I don't want to be late. You know? Because it's not like church is that long anyways. And I'm out here drinking. Like, I kind of felt convicted, you know, trying to walk to the house of the God. I mean, trying to walk inside the house of God after I've been out all night dancing and drinking. I want to get it together. Like, so I finally leave. I finally leave after, like, just not being in the groove of everything. And I didn't want to offend the person I was with. I'm not there. Like, we all have our times in life where we're going to get it together. And I feel like this is my time. I'm giving God me in hopes that better will come out of situations where I've tried to do things myself. You know? I don't know what made me listen to God that night. I really don't know. And I just left the club. I don't know what made me do that. Like, I still have things I'm dealing with, you know, trying to work on myself. I have a bad mouth when it comes to cursing. I'm trying to deal with that. Because I'm a curser. I curse for no apparent reason. And as of recently, I've just been like, man, I need to stop cursing. Like, it's been hurting my ears hearing me curse. And I don't know. I think God is just slowly dealing with me about, like, in every category with different things. And I try not to drink a lot because I know there are issues in my family with people drinking, like needing to have a drink. Can't go a week without, you know, drinking. So I try to not drink often because I know already what it is in my family. So, but God has been dealing with me about the atmosphere I'm putting myself in, because I may be innocent minded, but other people are not, and intentions in that atmosphere are not pure. So I have to remove myself from it. Another thing, what's been apprehensive for me is just living for God and then, like, oh my gosh, being so boring. I don't want to be boring. I don't want to feel like I'm an old lady. I don't have children. I'm not in a relationship. So it's like, I want to live my life. I want to be, like, content, happy, and, you know, I don't want to feel like I'm old. And I always felt like I'm old. Even when I wasn't really putting God number one in my life, I always felt like I was old. Because I wasn't as free as other people are, I felt like. Like, I know a lot of people that are free, easy breezy free, like, do anything. And that's just not me. I tried it last summer, I was living my life. It wasn't my best life, but I was just trying to live to the fullest. And I had a fun time, you know? This summer, I've been more chill. One being, I've been working at this job. This job has been working me almost to my bone. Like, I've been doing too much. I'm gonna line my lips. So this is the Intense Butter Gloss in the color Cinnamon Roll. I saw this lip gloss on Pinterest, and it had black girls on it, and they look pretty. So I'm like, let me try this, because I've really been looking for, like, a nude type of lip product. I got these nails on, I can't open it.
To be by my side, the more I
my face feels like dry, but it's matte. It's matte. But it just, something looks different. I don't know. So I'm gonna try to put this, actually I'm gonna go for the darker golden today. I'm gonna try to like just put this on the bridge of my nose and go for more of a glowy look. Cause I don't know what's going on with my makeup today. So, and I haven't done my makeup in a while, so of course it's gonna be, you know, different. Okay, so I only have like two more questions and then I'm done. One would be like, what is your like goal in Christ? In January, I set a goal of just being closer to God and living for God. That was my goal because I've done a poor job in the past few years of like living for God. And of living, just living for God fully, you know? I've just, this is just my thing. Nothing actually made me want to do that but me. I could have, you know, I could have did a lot of things, but that's neither here nor there. I just want to put it out there. Like, I made that choice to live for God on my own. No situation pushed me, oh my God, let me live for God, except just going through, doing everything my way. Like, I guess I'm a hard learner, like, and I've learned lessons hard. Now that I've learned those hard lessons, I'm like, bruh, no more pain. Okay, no more pain. Let's just listen to God. Let's do it His way. A lot of our problems we face are like temporary. It's not like gonna last forever. But when we're going through those problems, we don't really think like, oh my God, this is only temporary. Like when I was going through problems of wanting to move out, it was temporary. Now I got my own place, it's my second apartment. Apartment tour coming soon. But that was a temporary problem, and like it was definitely solvable with God and with work. I know what I'm forgetting. I'm forgetting to put some concealer on right here, but it's too late now.
I wanna thank you for me. Oh, I wanna thank you for all that you've done for me. For all that you've done.
This is the finished product. This is my finished look. I haven't done my makeup in a while, so of course it's gonna be like different once you do it. So I don't know. Let me know if you guys like this type of video. Again, this is new to my channel. I'm not a new person, but I'm evolving. I feel like I'm maturing and I'm really just coming into my own woman. Like, it feels good, you know. It fluctuates day by day, but I actually have to thank God for being here. I thank God for, you know, kind of like restoring my mind, giving me a different perspective on life. So if you like these type of videos, please comment down below and follow me on this journey with God.